I feel sad for the people in the US. I genuinely wonder how people in the US cope. China promotes peace. The US doesn't. Today, I will be talking about why I prefer China over the US and why I believe China is a much better country than the US.
Yo, 大家好，这里是中国制造啤酒哥，那么欢迎来到我的频道。今天我们继续聊这位外国粉红小姐姐的话题，就是关于她为什么会觉得在中国生活比在美国生活更好。那在上一条视频当中呢，她说在中国生活更好的原因是因为中国的卫生状况会更好一些，吊打美国啊。有点夸张，但是我喜欢他的用词，我喜欢。说实话，我刚听他这么说的时候，我本来是想去反驳一下的。要知道多年前，一帮公知们可是天天没事就在网上说咱们的卫生环境多么多么的糟糕，国外的环境多么多么的干净整洁，蓝天白云的。这不阴降的空气都是香甜的，这个梗就是从那个时候来的。这位外国小姐姐放出了美国和中国街头这种卫生状况的视频对比，去证明他的观点。那后来肌肉哥自己也去找了点资料以后发现，在这一点上我真的没有办法去反驳这位粉红小姐姐。那顺便说一句，后来有网友给我留言说这是一位来自牙买加的小姐姐，她说她也喜欢这位小姐姐的视频，谢谢这位网友的科普。那今天我们在视频中，这位牙买加小姐姐说出了她认为最重要的一个原因，就是她为什么选择中国而不是美国。那让我们去看看她的这条原因说的是否能让视频前的你心服口服。
Another reason why I prefer China over the US is that China is simply more peaceful than the US. That's it. There's almost always some unrest.In the US, some protest, someone fighting with authority, someone challenging authority, something going on, almost always. I feel sad for the people in the US. I genuinely wonder how people in the US cope. With everything that is going on in the US now, I genuinely wonder how people are coping in the US. Check out this video 2 weeks ago in the US.I almost always something like this happening in the US. Unlike China, China promotes peace and harmonious relationship with colleagues, with friends.And family. That is the basis of Chinese culture, peace. And you can see how China is operating on the world stage right now. China is trying to approach every situation with peace. The basis of China's foreign policy is non-interference and respecting the sovereignty of other countries. Unlike the US, the US dictates.To other countries what they should do, who they should partner with, who they should trade with, and tell other countries, if you do this, we will not do this, and if you do that, we will not do that. That is US. China promotes peace. And when you will disrespect the sovereignty of another country, there cannot be peace on the world stage. And so, even on the world stage right now, China is promoting peace.But that USA, they continue to provoke China. They continue to put their nose in places that do not concern them and continue to provoke not only China, but other countries. And so, unlike the US, China is a peace-loving country. China is a country that promotes peace. And I will always prefer China over the US for this reason.Here in China, life is so peaceful. And I appreciate that so much. I really wonder how are people coping in the US? I genuinely wonder, with everything that is happening, how are you coping right now? Something is always disrupting the peace in the US. And so does the US on the world stage. Always doing something to threaten world peace. I believe that the US is one of the greatest threats to world peace in the world right now. Yes, because they cannot respect the sovereignty of other states. This is the truth. And they cannot just deal with their own issues. They cannot deal with their own issues. They cannot focus on things they need to focus on in their own country. No. They cannot. This is not enough for US. It is not enough for the US to focus on what is going on in their country. It is not enough for US to focus on all the social issues in their country. It is not enough for US to evaluate what is happening and why the things that are happening in their country are happening. It is not enough for them to do that. It is not enough. Right? It is no wonder why the American allies are reconsidering their position with the US. US is not a peace-loving country, unlike China. And so that is the number one reason why I prefer China over the US. China promotes peace. The US doesn't.
老实说啊，当我听到这里的时候，我觉得这位牙买加小姐姐的这条观点又再一次让我表示心服口服，无法反驳。那我们会发现，稍微看一看最近这些年的这种报纸啊新闻，就可以看出鹰将上升到国家层面，他们不懂得尊重世界其他国家的空间，也不懂得尊重别人的文化。那下到鹰将的一些人，他们也不懂得去尊重别人的空间，总是试图把他们的观点强加于别人。当然了，他们嘴上还是要顺带一句，他们是热爱自由的，热爱包容的。那说到这，肌肉哥不仅就会有一种恶心想吐的感觉。那本着做视频严谨的态度啊，为了不要冤枉鹰将，肌肉哥在看完这位牙买加小姐姐的观点后，就去网上搜索了一下关于鹰将人民的生活方式的这种资料，结果无意间就发现这个愤怒消费的鹰将小伙，鹰将精神小伙，这就其实发生在前两天，我们知道啊，消费购物对普通人来说本应该是一件愉快放松的事情，但是鹰将的一些精神年轻人，他们偏不，购起物来就非常的愤怒疯狂。那从视频中我们可以看出，这位精神小伙他的购物欲确实很强啊，都是整个货柜这样的搬。难道作为代表灯塔的鹰将是想向我们展示他们这种来自未来的购物方式？这难道就是传说中的赛博朋克购物形式？我不懂啊，我真的不懂啊，这样的购物模式我也是从来没有在国内看过啊，但是这样的购物模式到底对鹰将好还是不好，我真的因为我不懂，所以我不发表意见，免得某些人又心碎一地，乱给哥贴标签，你就是讨厌鹰将，你就是嫉妒鹰将，所以我不发表意见。但是即使如此，我相信视频前的你应该能感觉到这位美国精神小伙他这种在购物时的这种美式愤怒。
These police are mostly indoctrinated as well. They're afraid of the mob. Afraid they do anything. Keep law and order. The end of this. So it's cowardice for everybody all around.
People probably want. How do you keep your composure? How do you keep composure?
You. 我每天都会有好几次就感觉不真实，你知道吧？就过一会儿就觉得，哎，我他妈到美国了。过一会儿就觉得，哎，我他妈到美国了。好开心啊。哎呀。
如果说上一段视频大家还无法感觉到那种特有的美式愤怒，那这段视频小伙伴们一定能够通过这种不断的哔哔哔这种屏蔽音感受到，其实想想这样也挺好的，毕竟歌都省得翻译了，屏蔽的都是那段经典的英语短语固定搭配，我想视频前大部分小伙伴应该都知道是什么。要知道开始动手打人的可是那些代表着世界人类未来文明的 LGBTQ 群体，就是那种号称少数，对吧，那种弱势群体，就是那群总把博爱平等和包容挂在嘴边的那群人。当然可能有的小伙伴会问啊，肌肉哥他们为什么要打人呀，是不是那位站在那里的大哥做了什么人神共愤的事情？其实那位站得笔直的大哥就是想呼吁一下英将社会应该反对给孩子做变性手术，仅此而已。在英将那里这种充满激情与愤怒的例子还有很多，由于今天视频时长的原因哥就不在这里一一例举了。当然我知道一些电子宠物和精神美国人他们还是会说这些都是个案，不能代表普遍的英将，咱们祖国也有那种街头冲突的事情啊，你怎么不说呢？当然肌肉哥在这里不想再去提硬将什么 biu 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 的问题了，再提我相信小伙伴们耳朵都起茧子了，同时哥也累了，实在不想和这些精神美国人去争什么。我知道争到最后一定是他们赢，毕竟嘛，他们对这个世界的认知完全都是建立在他们的想象世界当中的，他们那套强大的精神逻辑已经达到了造物主神的级别，哥怎么能跟神去争呢？视频最后肌肉哥还是想对懂的小伙伴们说一句，我相信我们大多数人都不讨厌英将，就像视频中那位牙买加小姐姐所说一样，我们中国人是热爱和平的，我们也不爱管英将家里的那点糟心事儿，他们那种很多鸡鸡蛋蛋的问题说实话在我看来挺无聊的，我都不知道他们在争什么。肌肉哥之所以想向大家展示英将家发生的各种名场面，是希望大家能够更加清晰地意识到英将其实从来就没有那么好，咱们也没有那么糟糕，至少在我看来这个世界上很多人都发现咱们的祖国要比英将优秀太多了，我们要保持我们应该有的自信，多给自己一点耐心，我相信在不远的将来英将再这么玩下去，英将和咱们的这种差距会更加的明显。好了，今天就和大家聊到这里，希望大家一如既往喜欢我的内容，最后不要忘记一键三连 Peace。